guitarist, I play the instrument which so beautifully sits between the worlds of classical and mainstream, and when I think of Beatles, I don't really think about them as pop, I think about them as classics. I love Beatles music, I knew I could do something really, really great with it, and here we are. Abbey Road is the epicenter of creative energy of the Beatles. One of the most rewarding and special things on this album was that it allowed me to work with amazing musicians who are also my friends, with whom I've always wanted to do something. Tori Amos is a singer that I respect and admire so much, and I met her and I knew her personally before, and we just always clicked. And I knew that when we worked together, we would musically click as well.
I've always loved She's Leaving Home. I can't remember the first time I heard it. I must have been really young. And I had this vision of a girl leaving her parents and meeting this dashing young man somewhere. And as I got older, of course, I began to see myself as that girl leaving home. And then as I got yet older again, I began to see myself as the mother who had once been the girl that was leaving home, but now had the daughter that was leaving home. It's exciting when you have such a great player like Milos, to hear him play it was a breath of fresh air, though, for me.
And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me.
Gregory Porter, I mean, you don't need much introduction for him. He's already kind of a legend.
What I love about the Beatles' music is just the depth and breadth of who they are musically. It's so huge. It's sacred music. It's dance music. You know, there's music for every occasion. That's extraordinary and hard to do. And it takes time for that to happen. And so it was just a perfect storm of genius that created them.
They may be parted. There is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer.
Anushka Shankar, we cross paths in so many cities all over the world, and she's an absolute angel, one of the finest musicians in the world. Considering the Beatles, Ravi Shankar, George Harrison connection and so on, it was really a no-brainer. I love the sound of sitar, and nobody plays it better than Anushka. Steven Isilis, a dear friend, amazing cellist, the most beautiful, gorgeous voice on that cello. I played Michelle in a solo arrangement for many, many years, so I thought that on this album, if I do it, I want to do something different. So that's why I asked Steven to come in, and we sat down and we jammed a little bit on it, and it's a little bit like we were together at the Wigmore Hall or somewhere like that and just wanted to do an encore. I'm so happy with what we have with this album, and I can't wait for people to hear it, because I think it gives a different sound to the songs that we all know and love and adore.